that was as nerve tingling a limited overs game as you could possibly imagine.
This is why we love the game. The ebb and flow of this game was amazing. Yeah. At one stage at 140 something, 149, you thought, listen, there's no way Chennai ain't going to win this. And then there was a stage when you thought, how are Chennai going to win this? And they went down to the last over and you said one run. I beg to differ, it was 1 millimeter. that's the Dhoni run out. If he was 1 millimeter ahead, he would have been knocked out. Yes. And Chennai would have won the game. So look, this is what the fine margins are. It was unbelievable. I mean, this is why we love the game.
Chennai did their best actually to, or Mumbai rather, did their best to actually lose the game, but ended up winning it because they kept dropping catches. In fact, they dropped so many catches of Shane Watson, who in the end carried Chennai to within touching distance of the title.
Yeah, it was quite a, you know, erratic performance in the field by Mumbai. There were actually many inflection points. I think he's, you know, he's, as he mentioned, 1 millimeter for Dhoni, you don't know what might have happened. But also, Suresh Raina dropping Hardik Pandya when he was 4 or 6.
Yes.
And even 10 runs more, you can imagine what a difference it's made to the match. The, you know, the catches dropped. And of course, let's not forget the last delivery bowled by Malinga. He had gone for so many runs.
Yes.
And then, you know, he, this is where experience matters. So
because there was a choice to be made there, whether to get Malinga to bowl that last over
or
Hardik Pandya. And Rohan, in the back room, you were saying you would have gone for Hardik actually.
Yeah, and that's why I'm not captain of Mumbai. Because I thought Rohit Sharma got it spot on when in the end, when he got the experience of Malinga. Yes, he went for that one big over against Watson, but Watson wasn't there. So he relied on the fact that, look, Malinga's got enough experience. He's going to be bowling to two batsmen who he felt he would come up on top against. But, you know, just going back about, you talk about the fielding. Quinton de Kock in that previous, the penultimate over against...
letting four runs go through.
Yeah, Bumrah.
Yes.
And again, one other thing, the Dhoni run out came out because of some not so smart cricket on the overthrow. Now, generally, if it wasn't a millimeter, you saw Rohit Sharma's reaction. You're like, what's going on? Why?
Yeah.
But fortune favors, well, I'm not going to say the brave over here, but fortune favored the Mumbai Indians. And they got that run, which turned out to be the turning point.
Yeah, lots of fortune, yes, but also credit to the heroes of Mumbai throughout this performance. Yes, Rahul Chahar dropped a sitter, dropped a cotton bowl, but he was exceptional with the ball. And Jasprit Bumrah, every game he plays is worth his weight in gold, isn't he?
Oh, absolutely. Rahul Chahar, in my opinion, has been the, you know, after Imran Tahir, and Imran Tahir maybe twice his age,
yes,
you know, with that wealth of experience. But he's been superb as a leg spinner. He's been in and out of the Mumbai Indians team, but whenever he's come back, he's just looked so good. And not just against, you know, the ordinary batsmen, so to speak, even against the big international stars or the India international players, he's just been so impressive. And Bumrah, he's, what can one say more of him? What we've seen him perform in the last year in all formats, in test matches, ODIs, T20s. There's a Hindi word, I think it's called achamba.
Yes. He's 2 for 14 in this game, Rohan. It's a big final.
No,
and he's not lost his composure even when those buys have gone off Quinton de Kock.
Yeah.
He's kept his calm throughout that performance.
No, even after those buys of Quinton de Kock on that last delivery of his spell, he went up to Quinton de Kock afterwards, put his arm around him and said, listen, mate, don't worry. It happens to the best of him. I mean, I'm paraphrasing over here. But he was up there consoling his teammates and saying, listen, don't worry about it. We can still win this game. And that's exactly what happened. But I'd just like to talk a little bit more about Rahul Chahar. You spoke about, you know, how good and impressive he's been bowling to the best. It's not just his bowling. His body language.
Yes.
His body language has been immaculate. It shows that he believes that he belongs at this stage, which is always a plus sign, because he seems like a kid who has a lot of self-confidence.
Yeah.
And it's not unfounded. That self-confidence is well-placed because he's shown he's got the skill set, but it's that body language. It's amazing.
Another hero for Mumbai, and I'll get Ayaz's thoughts as well, Rohan, but just from you, was Kyron Pollard when they were batting first, because they got off to a good start, but then stumbled, and pretty much Chennai played to template. Started getting the spinners in, started choking the runs off. And Pollard, yet again, big final, big player comes through.
Well, this is where Pollard, after the match, said, look, we just want to get as many runs as we can on board, because scoreboard pressure will tell. And he did that. Look, I've got to be honest, I didn't think they had enough on board. I thought they were about 10-15 short. But just the way they fought back. And again, you know, the kind of start that Chennai got, you know, with Faf du Plessis batting well, that opening partnership, you thought this game was going to run away from Mumbai Indians.
Yes.
But, you know, full credit to Pollard. Even Hardik Pandya, a little cameo in the end. And he's been superb. He's been superb throughout the season. I haven't seen someone with such clean striking for a consistent period. I can't remember.
You'd
probably remember Ayaz because you've definitely seen a lot more cricket than me. Yeah, but I can't remember.
Not since Kapil Dev.
Andre Russell and Hardik Pandya this year.
Yes. The other aspect of this game, let's not forget Chennai's contribution to the thrills that we actually saw in this contest. Pretty much a team that was, you know, you've got all sorts of names going around for them, Dad, Zami, all of that. But again, Shane Watson proving the value of experience in a contest of this kind, playing an absolute blinder.
Yes, I think they actually, you know, took a punt all season on Watson. Yes. And he's come good in the last two games. He couldn't win this match, but he just almost did it. I think one of the things that has struck me about Chennai, and it's not this season alone, it's right from the, you know, from the inception of the, you know, there is a certain faith formula that you employ.
Yeah.
They have faith in the players. They persist with them. They've kept their core team pretty much the same for the last, you know, 10 editions that they participated in. And it just seems to help them. Whenever the chips are down, these players stand up and deliver. You know, 8 times in the final. Yes, Mumbai have now nudged ahead in the number of finals won. And Mumbai have actually now got pretty much a similar strategy. Yeah. Last season, they punted a lot on the younger players, but they've also got a lot of, regulars the core team remains the same.
I just want to say one thing. I agree with you. I think, you know, Mumbai have got the core team strength the same. Don't make too many changes. Where CSK are concerned, though, with this entire strategy of having experienced players, I think it works only because they've got MS Dhoni as captain behind the stumps. If you have another captain, it's not going to work. So when MS Dhoni retires, whenever that may be, they're going to have to rip this blueprint. Yeah. And they've got to have to come up with a new blueprint where they come up with younger players, players who are more, probably less experienced than the guys they've got now, but they'll have to rip this blueprint.